Hey there, drummers and drum fans. This is Bazybeats coming to you on video from the Bazy couch today in Tampa Bay, Florida. So, the most popular question I get lately is, how do you tune your drums, Bazy? And even more importantly, how do you tune your snare? So many of my emails come from that I decided today I'm going to have to show you just exactly how I tune my snare. Now, I want you to know, gang, that I don't consider myself to be some god of tuning. I'm not like the tuning guru. But enough of you have asked, how do I get the sound that I'm getting? And I figured I would go ahead and show you. So again, I'm not doing this because I think that I'm some great tuning master. But if you want to see how I do it from my experience and knowledge and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of tunings later, I'm willing to show you. But there's a lot of information that's going to be packed in this video. I'm going to be, unfortunately, talking very quickly in order to get it all out. So bear with me, and maybe you'll learn something today. Check it out. If you've got other ideas, by the way, on how to tune drums, that's fine. By all means, put it into the comments block. Again, I'm not the greatest at tuning, but I'm going to show you my way. If you've got other suggestions, hit me up with a comment. Let's let everybody see it. Any rate, let me get started. Okay, gang, first thing to do is to make sure you've got the right drum. Having a good snare drum is about 90% of the tuning problem, because I've tuned all kinds of snare drums in my time playing drums, and some of them you can make sound good, and some of them just need to go in the garbage. This drum, though, I didn't buy because of the color. It's kind of black. It doesn't really match the purple kit that I have. I didn't buy it because of the make. You see, I'm a pearl guy myself, and this happens to be a Tama drum. It's exactly a Mike Portnoy signature snare Melody Master. So if you want one for yourself, that's what you buy. It's a 12-inch snare. It's got a nice high pop sound to it, and I played several snare drums the day that I bought it and picked it because it had, honestly, the best sound as far as I was concerned. Now, once you've got the right sounding snare, the next thing you want to do is have a good head. I usually use coated Remo Weather King ambassadors on my snares. Don't ask me why. It's just I've tried lots of other snare drums heads, and these, I think, get the best sound for a snare. I've tried the pinstripes, the clears, the coateds, the hydraulics, the darks, but I think this gives me the best pop, very crisp sound. Not every drummer will like that, but that's what I go for. Okay, so now that you've got the proper drum, or the right drum for you, and the right snare drum head that you're looking for to get the proper sound you want, the next thing is the actual tuning. Now, this is the way I've learned it. First off, I take and I put the head on, and then I put the ring down on top, and I get all the lugs down in, and I twist them all to where I can do it with my right hand and get like what we call finger tension on each lug. And I do that, I start out with one lug and I'll cross down to the opposite lug across from it. Then I'll go over to a lug that will cross that lug. So if I start here and I go down here, my next two lugs would be these two, so that I can get a nice cross pattern going. And try to get as directly across the drum going like an X as you can until you've hit all of them. So it would kind of look like this. Here, to here, to here, to here, to here, to here. And that would totally cross all the way. And that gives you a nice equal tuning all the way around. While you're going from here to here and here to here and like a star pattern across your drum, you want to make sure that you're turning each time the same amount. Past the finger tension part, then you're going to get your drum key and you're going to do about a half a turn or a quarter of a turn, depending on how far you are into the tuning. Because as you get tighter, you want to use less and less, smaller and smaller increments as you're crossing the drum. That gives it a nice, even, and perfect tune. There's also a special drum key made that I just started using recently, although I've owned one for quite some time. This is made by Evans, and you can actually dial in with the little dial here the exact amount of tension that you want on the drum, and then as you're tuning it, the top part will snap loose when you've tuned it enough, when it's to the exact same tension as the last one you tuned. And that one works really well. I tried it a couple of nights ago and ended up with a really good bass for my tuning to start right there. But even if all you have is just a regular old drum key, you start out by tuning, let's say, one full turn, and you do one full turn on each lug. And then you can lay the drum on the floor so it dampens the sound of the bottom head, and then you tap each tap the snare head in front of each lug about a half an inch, maybe a quarter of an inch inside the lug. You hear that? This one's going ping, 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 ping. So there's a little variation there. This drum still needs to be tuned a little bit more. Yesterday about this time, I tuned this drum. And about 24 hours later, once the drum head starts to settle in, you may need to adjust, fine tune a little bit more. And I always try to make sure that I haven't tuned the drum quite as tight as I really want it until after it's had time to kind of sit and stretch for 24 hours. Because you don't want to loosen, if at all possible. You want to make all your fine adjustments by tuning up instead of down, because that's going to stretch the head a little bit more. If you have to tune down, then the drum is already stretched out, and then it kind of warps a little bit. It's not as good, trust me. Just go up and not down. It's not going to happen for you the first time you try tuning. You're probably going to have to tune down a couple of times while you're learning, getting the feel for it. Don't fret that. That's okay. Also, be prepared for a lot of popping noises while you're tuning. When a brand new head gets on a drum and you first start tuning it and you're doing it right, you may get some fairly loud snap and crackling noises. You may even think you've cracked the head. But trust me, you don't. You have to really crank a drum head to get it to totally break. So you're going to hear some popping and crackling. It's okay. Don't get freaked out about it. Once you get done tuning the top and the bottom using the little lug theory that I just showed you and tightening them equally, you may have a sound that has some after ring to it. If you don't like that, don't put tape on it. If you can, spend the money and get these little Remos, they're called, and you stick it on the head. This one doesn't fit. Let's try another one. Here's a 12-inch Remo. And I'll stick that right down onto the head. And you see, it totally takes care of the problem. You do not need to put tape on these to hold these down. They will stay on there no matter how hard you play. And they won't. It doesn't matter even if the drum is up at an angle. They will still stay on. And they're real easy to pull right off in case you got a song that requires some ring to it, like maybe you're doing a little reggae, and then you switch to some rock. You can throw these on very quickly, and it tightens it right up. There's also these little gel things that you can stick on and take right off, and I would suggest you Google those or try some online music stores to look for gel dampers or snare dampers or gel something. You'll find them. The last resort would be to take some duct tape or something and stick it on here, like put a piece across here for starters. And if that doesn't take care of it, then put a piece across here and then another one at an angle across here. I've seen drummers to where they've got them all the way around. I've seen them where they've made targets or crisscrosses across from each of their lugs. Whatever floats your boat. But I would rather not have that sticky mess all over my drums. And I also, like I said, might want to play some reggae in a moment's notice, and I can take that off without pulling all this tape off and then having all that nasty tape lines and messy garbage stuck to my head. So consider that as well. So that about sums it up from my experience in tuning drums. And again, I'm not necessarily the best drum tuner there is. So if any of you have other comments, suggestions, or ideas out there on getting that perfect tune, by all means, put a comment down on this page and let me know, let others know what you think, and we can share information that way. I'd like to see more of you out there talking back and forth using my comments pages. It's a wonderful tool and a way for us to share information. That's really what it's all about. by all means as well, comment me on my videos. It helps me to decide how to do my next videos and what I should do, etc. So that's about it for Bazybeats for today on snare drum tuning. Until next time, you guys take it easy and have fun drumming. Good day.